You should never compromise on your personal safety. You need to protect yourself from sexual assaults and from potentially abusive partners. Adopting certain safety habits will harden you as a target and prevent you from appearing on a predator's radar. You have to understand why predatory and aggressive individuals act and behave the way they do. This will enable you to respond effectively to them and their threat.
This program is aimed at helping you understand the psychology behind why men behave aggressively towards women. Every day we are faced with some form of abuse, sexual assault, and we hear of so many cases of rape. The goal here is to empower you to be able to foresee, avert, and avoid violence and recognize individuals who intend to harm you. With what you learn here, you will be better positioned to make quick assessments of situations where harmful intent is present and find the most effective way to get out of it.
Our vision is to educate you to be aware of what is happening around you. We want you to be able to make dynamic risk assessments of situations where you will find harmful intent to be present.
We also look to empower you in a way where you can defend yourself in a dangerous situation. Confidence is key. We do not want you to display fear, but handle the situation to the best of your ability to ensure that there is no harm caused.
We want you to be able to foresee, avert, and avoid a violent and dangerous situation. Once you have established this, you will be able to prevent a physical confrontation before it can even happen and save yourself from unwanted harm.
How many times have you told yourself, "It will never happen to me"? How often have you said, "I move only among well-educated people. They are not rapists"?
Have you ever doubted your own ability to act in a situation? How many times have you assured yourself that he is stronger and you will not be able to subdue him? How often have you told yourself that you are too weak, fragile, or out of shape to defend yourself? You may think you do not dress provocatively and therefore do not draw unwanted attention to yourself. You somehow feel safe around well-educated people. You believe that a friend or a family member cannot harm you. What if we tell you that these are all myths. Being aware of every situation you are in terms of where you are, what you are doing, and the people who are around you is the most important thing. Reading human body language is a skill. It requires you to be focused and well aware. People will do or say things which could indicate whether they are a threat to you or not. Someone who stares at you excessively, who comes too close to you, who brushes past you repeatedly and says sorry. These actions will help you anticipate an assault or attack. You want to de-escalate or resolve a conflict you are in. For that, you need to be confident enough to take control of the situation. Now, this is easier said than done. We have a section later in this program where we help you with steps on how to take control and remove yourself from the situation before it is too late. If you are unable to remove yourself from a situation before it is too late, we want you to be able to fight back your attacker so that he doesn't think he has an easy target. Never think that you are too weak, fragile, or out of shape, because that is where half your battle will be lost. There are many resources available online that teach you easy yet effective ways to get yourself out of danger. As we go through the program, we list out steps you should take post an incident. What needs to be done depends on the situation you have been in, and we have provided some suggestions in relation to this.